Welcome back to the RIU Good Oil Conference in Fremantle. Today we are joined by Aidan Bradley, Director of Corporate Finance, Patterson Securities. Welcome, Aidan.
Thank you.
Aidan, what is the outlook for the oil and gas sector in 2014-2015?
Thankfully, a little bit better than it was. The last couple of years for small cap resources in general in Australia has been a really terrible 24-month period. If you look at the index performance, it's probably down about 80% from its peak. We're pretty much now back to the beginning of 2005 levels, so about 5/6 of the China-led boom in resources in Australia in terms of share price performance has been reversed. Thankfully, within the oil and gas space, within the resources universe, the outlook is starting to look slightly more positive as we view forward, particularly around commodity pricing, where oil and gas internationally, from a pricing perspective, is a lot more robust than we're seeing in some other commodities in Australia, such as iron ore, for example.
What is the current sentiment for the oil and gas sector in the Australian market?
It's improving from that very low base, and a lot of that improvement's around the commodity pricing that we have in the oil and gas sector. Significantly more positive than you see in a lot of commodity areas, such as iron ore here in Australia. For example, oil is still trading over $100 a barrel, both internationally and in the US. For someone that's been in the industry about 18 years, that's an incredibly positive operating environment for our stocks. I think the companies have performed poorly over the last couple of years for reasons beyond that. A lot of them were too small, a lot of them were exposed to just single licenses and single wells. I think we've started to see consolidation in the space, which is building up companies' competencies and capabilities. And I think looking forward with $100 oil, I think you are going to start to see an improvement, not just in terms of operational performance, but hopefully share price performance as well.
What do you see are the key risks and opportunities for the junior oil and gas players?
The major risk is around the competitive landscape, the complexity of now doing business in the oil and gas sector. If you look back 5, 10, 15, 20 years, you know, your average cost of an onshore well might have been a few million dollars. Now you're talking 15, 20, 25 million for some of these horizontal multi-frac wells. And offshore well costs can get into the 100, 150 million. So given the high cost and the complexities of now operating in oil and gas, I think if you look at the 150 or so listed companies that we have here in Australia in the oil and gas sector, to be honest, a lot of them would be considered too small and too under-resourced to really build a competitive advantage and be successful in what is a very, very competitive industry.
Great. Thank you very much for your time today, Aidan.
No problem. Thank you.